Welcome back to Matt's Basement Workshop.
Matt's Basement Workshop is proudly sponsored by Highland Woodworking, your dependable online resource for woodworking tools, books, and supplies. With quick delivery to all 50 states, Highland is home with the legendary wood slicer bandsaw resawing blade. Visit them today at highlandwoodworking.com.
So in the last episode, we went ahead and we attached the horizontal face frame members. And one thing with the solid wood face frame is the fact that you can notice that it's rather narrow. And this kind of leads to like kind of a modern look, if you want to call it. I just thought it was kind of a neat. So it's about 7/8 to about an inch wide. And thus, obviously, even if I was using just my regular base plate, it would make it kind of treacherous. It would be a little off balance, as you could see there. So to help expand that surface space to make sure that my router will stay very flush with this and thus not have to worry about it going all over the place, I added that piece of scrap that you saw there and I just simply clamped it in place. So using a flush trimming bit, I go ahead and I get it to the right depth that I want to because I want the flush trimmer bearing to be on the shelf itself, and I start making my passes. Now it's really important to pay attention to grain direction because this is when you can get some really nasty tear out and you may find it necessary to do a climbing cut to avoid that. So I just take a few little passes here, then I'll go back, clean it up, and then I do another little pass, and you see how by taking these little steps, I get a really great result, and immediately I notice that it is absolutely flush. So I went ahead and I finished up the rest of the horizontal face frame, and of course I just sped this up for time's sake, obviously, but the most important thing I need to emphasize here, again, is take your time with this. It's better to spend a little extra time to get the result that you want now than having to come back and sand all those tear outs that you would end up getting. Now, the next thing we're going to do is we're going to move on to the vertical pieces for the face frame. Now, I already went ahead and I used my biscuit joiner and I cut the slots for the biscuits I'm going to be using to attach the face frame to it. So, as usual, I went ahead and I applied a little bit of glue to the slots themselves, and I'm now starting to put the biscuits in. Of course, once I get the biscuits in, what I like to do is I come back and I apply the glue over the top of the biscuits or anywhere where I notice that maybe there's a little bit of a dry spot in there. You don't need a lot of glue for these to work. Really, once they swell, they really hold everything in place. So I apply a little glue on the edges, and then, of course, I'll go back in and I'll do a little bit in the slot, kind of, you know, just to be safe. But again, you want to make sure you don't use too much so that it's gooping all over. So sped it up here a little bit, and we went ahead and we attached. And it's just a matter of, if you have everything lined up the right way, you should just be able to just use your hand and just knock it into position. Of course, it doesn't hurt to have a little mallet on the side to help persuade, but one thing to keep anything from marring, use a scrap piece to kind of act as a buffer so that you don't have to worry about damaging your face frame. All right, now I'm going to essentially do the same thing with the horizontal pieces, or with the vertical pieces, as you saw me do with the horizontal. Again, using a scrap piece acting as a wider surface to make sure that my router base doesn't go anywhere. Now, one thing I'm going to show this, I'm very proud of this. I should have clamped this in position, but I didn't. I was thinking that it would just simply stay in place if I held it down. But I did get a decent result on one of the vertical pieces. But as we'll see in just a second here, like I said, we were able to kind of flush it up there. Nice and a great result, except on one side where you could see, once it gets into focus here, I got this really nasty tear out. Again, it was because I didn't pay attention to grain direction. But a really neat tool that came out about this time was the Veritas small scraper plane. So I went ahead and I picked one up. I was really excited about getting my hands on this. And the neat thing with the scraper plane is this is extremely a great tool when it comes to dealing with grains that really a regular hand plane would just be horrible to work with because it tears it out, or in the case of a router of a bit, of course, as you can see, it did do the tear out. Just a matter of, as you saw me using the screwdriver, I put a slight camber into the blade itself, and then I come in and I start working in that area. The really super thing about scrapers, whether it's a scraper plane or card scrapers, is, like I said, it's fantastic for cleaning up any tear out from rather tricky grains that are kind of going in all different directions, or in my case where I just simply didn't pay attention, and if I had done a simple climbing cut versus just kind of following along in the direction that I went, I would have gotten a much better result. So I went ahead and I'm going to finish up here with this small scraper. The nice thing is I can control this quite a bit so that it stays flush where I need it, and I don't have to worry about the potential of blowing out the veneer because the blade goes right to the edges of the hand plane, so I can see exactly where it's going. And the end result was pretty darn clean. Very, very happy. You know, what do you think, Matt? Absolutely. Okay, so we have the vertical pieces for the face frame in place. We have the horizontal pieces. The base is coming along very nicely. Now, the one thing we need to do is we need to attach the top to it. So that's what we're going to do here. Again, we used biscuits, went ahead and cut all the slots for it, made my marks, and I got them all in place. I made sure that I had corresponding marks on the top itself. So I went ahead and I'm applying the glue to the slots, and then I went ahead and I applied the biscuits. Now you see I'm kind of coming in and filling in the gaps a little bit here with the glue. It's important that there's a lot of biscuits here. There's a lot of surface space, so it's very, very crucial to make sure that I work a little bit faster than I normally do. So I'm just going to kind of cut to the chase and kind of move along here. You can see me, I'm spreading the glue out to try and make sure that it gets where it needs to. I went ahead and I applied the glue to the biscuits because there's so many slots in the top itself. It'd be very, very difficult to get the glue in all the top slots and then not have it ooze out all over the base. So we're going to go ahead and start applying the base top here. And I like to try to get the middle and then I'll work the edges. So I'm going to go ahead and speed this up because this took a little while. Luckily, the glue didn't dry in the meantime. Otherwise, I would have been in a lot of trouble there. So again, using a couple of different mallets to help persuade. Helps if you've got the back kind of wedged in a little bit up against maybe a workbench or something so it doesn't move on you. But once I kind of got it going there, it was rather easy to get everything into the position that it needs to, nice and flush. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and clamp up the top to make sure that it's not going anywhere. And this is another one of those big jobs because at this point, for sure, I'm in danger of the glue setting. So I went ahead and put the first clamp in place. Now I'm going to get ready to put the second clamp in. And I have about, I'm going to end up putting about a minimum of 6 clamps on this. So here comes clamp number 3. Again, needed to work a lot faster than I did, but luckily I had a bit longer open time on the glue. I was very, very lucky. I have a feeling it was a lot of the humidity that was in there. You can see me just sweat myself off there. Now I got the ones on the outsides in place, and the middle started to bow a little bit. So I'm just going to use a little persuasion with a mallet and a scrap and get it down in position. And yeah, I'm pretty satisfied with that. You saw the head nod there. So now we'll just go ahead and we'll apply a couple of clamps in the middle to make sure that it stays in place and it doesn't end up moving on us. So we'll go ahead and we'll apply that last clamp. And I think we're going to call it good for this particular session. So this means the base is almost finished. The only thing we need to do now is apply the wrap to the top itself. And then this is going to be our final end product right here. So in the next episode coming up, we're going to be starting to work on the hutch, and we're going to put the wrap on the base itself. So until then, I'll be talking to all of you later. Straight grains and sharp blades. Take care, everybody.
Matt's Basement Workshop has been proudly sponsored by Highland Woodworking of Atlanta. With quick delivery to all 50 states, the finest woodworking tools and supplies, including their famous wood slicer bandsaw resawing blade. Visit them today at highlandwoodworking.com.